हेलो एवरीवन, आई विल टीचिंग यू साइंस टू द फर्स्ट लेसन हेरेडिटी एंड एवोल्यूशन। नाउ बिफोर गेटिंग स्टार्टेड विद एवोल्यूशन वी नीड टू नो सर्टेन फैक्ट्स अबाउट एवोल्यूशन और सर्टेन फैक्ट्स अबाउट द यूनिवर्स। साइंटिस्ट आर ऑल्सो नॉट 100% श्योर ऑन दिस। द यूनिवर्स वॉज फॉर्म 10 बिलियन ईयर्स अगो। अर्थ केम इन टू एग्जिस्टेंस समथिंग अराउंड 4.5 बिलियन ईयर्स अगो एंड लाइफ केम ऑन अर्थ अराउंड 3.5 billion years ago. Now you may be wondering, when life came on Earth, how exactly our Earth looked like, or what were the conditions that prevailed on Earth? At that time, the Earth was a hot fireball. It had high temperature prevailing it. It had gases like ammonia, CH4, H2, helium, and water vapor present. You may be wondering, was oxygen present on Earth? No, oxygen was not present at that time, before life came on Earth. Fe and nickel, yani ki iron and nickel, they were present on the core of the Earth. And UV rays were also present. And there was abundance of photochemical reaction during that time. Now let's get started with the lesson. So we move on to evolution. So I gave you a brief introduction of how the universe was there before life came on Earth. Now evolution basically is not a fast process. It does not happen overnight. Evolution is a very slow, or you can say a gradual process. So as you can see in the first point, evolution is a gradual change occurring in living organisms over a long duration. This is a very slow process through which development of organism is achieved. Formation of new species due to change in specific characters of several generations of living organism as a response to natural selection is called evolution. I'll be discussing that when we proceed further in the video. So evolution, for learning about evolution, I'll give you a simple example. Now for example, you have an embryo. That embryo develops into a child. A child develops into a teenager. A teenager into a adult. So you see how human beings have evolved. How does a human being grow from being a baby to a grown-up person? That's evolution. So it doesn't happen overnight. What we should know, that this doesn't happen overnight. Similarly, the current generation, it hasn't, or it did not appear on the earth suddenly. It took them millions of years or crores of years to appear on the surface of the earth. Okay, so exactly how much time it takes for evolution to take place? It took about 300 crore years for evolution to take place. 300 crore years for evolution to take place. Then you come on to the next slide. There are different theories which explain evolution. The gradual theory of evolution is being accepted. There are many people propose the theory of evolution. Many people propose their theories, but not everything is accepted. Only the theories which give you the exact facts and evidences are accepted. So theory of evolution we are going to learn about. So what does the theory of evolution say? The theory of evolution says that the first living organism which was found on the earth's surface was protoplasm. And where was it found? It was found in ocean. And where was it found? It was found in ocean. Okay. Now, in due course of time, unicellular organisms were formed. Gradually, these changes occurred in the unicellular organisms from which larger and more complex organisms were formed. Duration of all these changes is at the most 300 crore years. Just like I have told you before, 300 crore years. Then you come under the definition of evolution. This definition is required from your board's point of view. So what is evolution? Progressive development of plants and animals from their ancestors having different structural and functional organization is called evolution. डेवलपमेंट हो रहा है प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स का उनके एंसेस्टर्स के से. नो अंडरस्टैंड, ह्यूमंस के एंसेस्टर्स आपको पता है कि एप्स थे, तो एप्स आर कम्प्लीटली डिफरेंट. तो एप्स से जो अभी करंट जो ह्यूमंस दिखते हैं वो स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शन दोनों में भी अलग अलग है. ओके, सो आई बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन द नेक्स्ट पीपीटी. सो प्रोग्रेसिव डेवलपमेंट ऑफ प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स फ्रॉम द एंसेस्टर्स हैव बीन डिफरेंट स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज कॉल्ड एवोल्यूशन. नेक्स्ट वी हैव एविडेंसेस ऑफ एवोल्यूशन. अभी एवोल्यूशन हो गया, जैसे कि अगर मैंने बोला कि ह्यूमंस के एंसेस्टर्स एप थे या फिर एप्स के डिसेंडेंट्स ह्यूमन है, तो ये प्रूफ करने के लिए यू रिक्वायर एविडेंसेस. तो कोई भी चीज़, अगर आप कोई भी थियोरी प्रपोज कर दो, उसको प्रूफ करने के लिए यू रिक्वायर एविडेंसेस. एविडेंस आर नथिंग बट प्रूफ्स. ओके, नाउ देयर सिक्स एविडेंसेस विच एक्सप्लेन आवर थ्योरी. फर्स्ट इज मॉर्फोलॉजिकल एविडेंसेस, सेकंड एनाटॉमिकल एविडेंसेस, थर्ड आर वेस्टिजियल लॉगिंग, फोर्थ आर पैलियंटोलॉजिकल एविडेंसेस, फिफ्थ आर कनेक्टिंग लिंक्स, सिक्स आर एम्ब्रियोलॉजिकल एविडेंसेस. वी विल लर्निंग मोर अबाउट देम इन डिटेल. लेट्स मूव अहेड. मॉर्फोलॉजिकल एविडेंसेस, मॉर्फोलॉजिकल एविडेंसेस, जैसे कि अगर मैंने बोला कि अभी एविडेंसेस एवोल्यूशन को प्रूव करने के लिए आपको एविडेंस चाहिए. नाउ वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट ऑल दी ऑर्गेनिजम्स हैड अ कॉमन एंसेस्टर. जैसे कि प्रोटोप्लाज्म से इतने बहुत सारे ऑर्गेनिजम्स इवॉल्व हुए, वैसे ही बहुत सारे अभी जो ऑर्गेनिजम्स है उनके उनका उनके सबका एक कॉमन एंसेस्टर था. दे ऑल हैड अ कॉमन एंसेस्टर. नाउ टू प्रूव दिस आई नीड टू गिव यू सम एविडेंस. नाउ to prove this, let's go for the first evidence, that is called morphological evidences. So if you have a pen and paper, please note it down that morphological evidences are nothing but external evidences. What are they? External evidences are the evidences which you can identify by observing an animal externally, by observing an animal externally. Now if you see the first diagram, dog, a goat, oh sorry, a dog, a sheep and a fox. Okay, a dog, a sheep and a fox, what do you see identical in them? You see their jaw structure being identical, you see their jaw structure being identical, their nose is being identical, their ears are being identical. Okay, so this similarities come to a conclusion that this animals, dog, sheep, fox, they had a common ancestor. Next you see the diagram of plants, you see a fruits, you see three types of different fruits, but they are identical in nature. Okay, they are oval in nature. Similarly, what does this conclude? That this three plants belong to a common ancestor. Okay, this three plants belong to a common ancestor. Let's move ahead. Then we come on to anatomical evidences. Okay, morphological evidences were based on external appearance of an organism. Anatomical evidences are based on internal structure of an organism. Internal structure means what? What do you mean by internal structure? It basically means the bone structure of an organism. By looking at the bone joints or the bone structure, you can see that these organisms had a common ancestor. Now, for anatomical evidences, I'll give you two different types of organs. They are not mentioned in your textbook, but I'll be explaining them so that you understand them in more depth and in more detail, and it will obviously help you in your higher standards. So there are two types of organs. First are homologous organs and second are analogous organs. So what are homologous organs? Homologous organs are those organs which have a common origin but they have different function. Now for example, you see a human hand and four leg of fox. They all have a common origin. Common origin का मतलब उनका ancestor common है. कैसे बोल सकता हमें common है? क्योंकि अगर हम उनके joints check करोगे तो joints at particular places are same. So it means they have a common origin, but their function are not same. A human hand is used for picking up things, throwing a ball and all such stuff. But four leg of fox is used for walking. Okay, so this was an example of homologous organs. I'll give you one more example. A human hand and a flipper of whale. Human hand is used for picking up things, throwing a ball, जैसे कि मैं पहले बताया. And a flipper of whale is used for swimming. They both of them have common origin, but they perform different function. Next, let's talk about analogous organs. So what are analogous organs? Analogous organs are those organs which have same function but not the same origin. So now I'll give an example. Now for example, wings of a bird and wings of an insect, they do not have same origin but they have same function. What is the same function? The function of flying.